Hey, what's up, Transformer fans and collectors? Sports Wolf 3 here, bringing you a cool little Transformers goodie. This one I happened to get from Dennis Pizdet 79, one of his contests a little while ago, and I happened to win that. And he sent me a few of these, and one of them was Megatron from the Generations line. This is the Cybertronian Megatron. Here's the package. Yep, you've all seen it. There it is. Yeah, whatever. Don't worry about the package so much. Anyway, let's see. Let's take a look at this guy. There's the top view. Not too bad. Not too shabby. I like it. It's not the worst I've seen from Megatron. They have made plenty of other molds of him that look like crap. But this one's not too bad. Here's the side. Don't like this, though. Don't like this whole thing. You can see his hands and everything. I don't understand that. I've checked and I've messed with it, and that's pretty much how it goes. So I do like the cannon. Cannon is very nice. It does fire, so you can see right here. If you push this button, this will shoot out, and then it locks back into place. So there you go. There's the quick view of his Cybertronian vehicle mode. So, not that bad. Not that bad at all. So, considering you're not looking at the figure from underneath all the time, so who really cares about what it looks like underneath the whole kibble thing? I mean, it's almost pointless to even. Now, if there was crap sticking out all over the sides and the top and everything, it'd be different. But so, for that matter, kibble is a term I will probably never use again. Anyway, let's go ahead and transform this guy. There's the cannon. I do like it. It is very nice. It's a nice feature. They probably could have made it bigger. I'm just kidding. No. Anyway, let's go ahead and start flipping and flopping this guy around. Get this guy transformed. Start by just pulling the sides off here. Just like that. And bring this down here, push those up, then this comes here, oops, sorry, out of camera here, can bring this, let's see if I can back that up a little, give you a better view. Okay, so see, these are the arms here. So you need your trusty pen cap. What you want to do is take your pen cap, pop these hands out of here, because unless you have long nails, it's kind of hard to do, because they keep the hands in these tracks here, which is kind of odd. I mean, well, where else would you put them, right? But still, I don't like that feature at all. What can you do? There's nothing you can do. Just bitch and complain. All right. Again, make sure you got your trusty pen cap or some kind of pointy little device to make sure you get these damn hands out of here. Anyway, now I need to snap that together like so. Yeah. No, only kidding. So, and then if you pull these down, like pull this down like this, pull this arm down, and then slide the arms over, spin them a little bit. It's kind of a simple transformation from vehicle to robot. Not a whole lot to explain. Then what you want to do is bring this chest piece right here, bring this right up, snap it right into his chest. And there you have it. Not a whole lot of complication going on here. And I do like his robot mode a lot. And then you can take his cannon and place it on his right arm or left, whichever you prefer. And then shoot the cannon at yourself while you're doing a video. Stay on there. go ahead and we'll put this right back in there. Try not to push that button while you're trying to pop that on there. So there you, oh man. Well, apparently my piece doesn't like me very much today because it obviously knows that I am an Optimus Prime fan and he is a Megatron. It doesn't like me just for that reason. Well, there you go, folks. There's big bad Megatron. Yes, indeed. A very, very, very nice looking mold. I like the robot mode way better than I do the vehicle mode. And not a whole lot going on. There's not a lot of extra crap. There's not a whole lot of anything, really. Everything kind of just goes together with this guy. I mean, I really like it. I like the head. He's got the G1 looking head, which is the standard. Everybody compares all these newer toys. If it's got some kind of G1 appeal to it or some kind of aspect. Or not aspect, some kind of look that reminds them of a G1 toy. Everybody just likes it. So why don't we just remake all the G1s? Just remake them. You know, just modernize them a little bit, but whatever. This is a close example of what you would do if you did that. I think that maybe Megatron deserves to have his G1 gun redone again. You know, snazz it up a little bit. But, well, there he is anyway, folks. Quick comparison. We'll compare him to, who I got handy sitting here. This guy right here. That's the, well, y'all know who that is. So, anyway, thanks for watching, and stay tuned for another Stiffman review. Thanks for watching.